Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 9.1, Problem 7. This is Section 9.1, Problem number 7. It says, Jane wants to make a 95% confidence interval for how many miles people drive each year. She has a random sample with a sample mean of 15,780 miles. Assume that she knows that the population standard deviation is 2,436 miles. Find a 95% confidence interval for a sample size of, and then we have a few different sample sizes. The sample size is going to get bigger and bigger. So let's start with the confidence interval formula, which is x bar plus or minus sigma over square root of n times z sub c. So next, let's fill in the formula. X bar is for the sample mean, and it says in the question, sample mean of 15,780. Plus or minus sigma, the population standard deviation, which is given as 2,436. Over square root of n. N is the size of the sample. So the sample size for part A is 36. And it'll have to be square root of 36. And then Z sub C is the confidence coefficient, which for 95% that they ask for in this question is 1.96. So now that it's filled in, what we need to do is deal with the square root first of all. So we'll have 15,780 plus or minus 2,436 divided by 6. Square root of 36 is 6. 6 times 6 is 36. And Z sub C stays on the end for now as 1.96. So the next thing I can do is divide 2,436 divided by 6. And it should be 406. I'll just verify that with my calculator to make absolutely sure. 2,436 divided by 6 is, 406. I was pretty sure. So 15,780 plus or minus 406 times 1.96. So the next step, I can multiply 406 times 1.96. So at that point, I will have 15,780 plus or minus. If I do 406 times 1.96, I'll have 795.76. So 795.76 would be called the margin of error. It's the one number value I get after the plus and minus, after I do the computation to get it down to one number. So now that I have one number after the plus and minus, what I can do is split this into a separate minus for the low end of the interval and a separate plus for the upper end of the interval. So the low end will be 15,780 minus 795.76, and the upper end will be the same numbers but with a plus, 15,780 plus 795.76. So the low end, let me do that subtraction. Will give me 14,984.24 to the upper end. This is something I can do without the calculator, but I just want to make really sure. Will be 16,575.76. So, what's the 95% confidence interval with a sample size of 36? It will be 14,984.24. 0.24 to 16,575.76. So if you have a sample of 36, you'd be pretty sure that the real population mean is somewhere in that range between 14,984 and 16,575 with some decimals. So now what happens if we increase the sample size from 36 up to 64? So the starting point would be very much the same. We're going to start with the same confidence interval formula. And it would fill in almost the same. The sample mean X bar would still be 15,780. The population standard deviation for sigma would still be 2,436. The N, the size of the sample, would change from 36 up to 64. So instead of square root of 36 underneath, I'll make it square root of 64. And the Z sub C, the confidence coefficient for 95%, is still going to be 1.96. So now, on the next step, when I do the square root of 64, it's not 6, square root of 64 is 8, because 8 times 8 is 64. And now moving forward from there, what I had before is 406 will change. 2436 divided by 8, you can do that with a calculator, 2436 divided by 8, doesn't look like it's quite going in even, 304.5. And now I can erase most of the stuff that comes after, because now it's going to start looking quite a bit different. So, at the next step, what I'm going to do is multiply 304.5 times 1.96. So that gives me a number of 596.82. So that would be my margin of error, 596.82. So now I can split that interval into a separate minus and a separate plus. So it'll be the sample mean of 15,780 minus the margin of error of 596.82. The upper end of my interval will be the same numbers but with a plus. The sample mean of 5,780 plus the margin of error of 596.82. Now, using the calculator, 15,780 minus 596.82, the low end of my interval will be 15,183.18, and the upper end, again, I'll do with the calculator just to be really sure, I get 16,376.82. So what's the confidence interval when I have a sample size of 64? It went to 15,183.18 to 16,376.82. So by increasing the sample size a little bit, the interval itself got smaller. So notice the distance between the upper end and lower end of our confidence interval is a little bit bigger with a smaller sample size, and it gets a little smaller when I push the sample size up to 64. So for part C, I would imagine that making the sample size even bigger, pushing it up to 100, will make that interval, the distance between the lower end and the upper end, even a little smaller still. And let's see if that's what actually happens. So, again, to start the process, find the confidence interval when your sample size is 100. It's still the same confidence interval formula. That won't change. The X bar or sample mean is still 15,780. That won't change. The sigma, the population standard deviation, is still 2,436. That won't change. The N, though, the size of the sample, that will change. It was 64 in the previous part of the problem, part B. It now goes from 64 to 100. The Z sub C, though, the confidence interval, confidence coefficient of 1.96, that stays because we still have 95% level confidence. So Now, to go to the next step, that square root of 100 now is not 8, it is 10. Square root of 100 is 10, because 10 times 10 is 100. And now, the result of 2, 4, 3, 6 divided by 10 will be 243.6. That I can do without a calculator. But moving forward from that point, I will need a calculator and I will need to erase more. So in the beginning, I can leave a lot of the stuff the same, but as I get near the end, this might as well just erase. So the next computation I'm going to have to do is 243.6 times 1.96. Clear my screen. 243.6 times 1.96 equals, and it gives me 477.456. That would be my margin of error, 477.456. Now, at that point, when I have one number after the plus and minus, I'll have a separate interval, split my plus and my minus. The minus will give me the low end of the interval. The plus will give me the upper end of my interval. So the low end will come from 15,780 minus 477.456 to the upper end of the interval. Again, same numbers but with a plus in between them, the sample mean of 15,780 plus the margin of error of 477.456. So now for the low end, when I subtract 15,780 minus 477.456, I get 15,302.544. And the upper end of that interval, 15,780 plus 477.456. Equals 16,257.456. So the last part of this question, well not quite the very last part, part C, for a sample size of 100, a 95% confidence interval is 15,302.54, again with a little bit of round off, to 16,257.46. Again, round it a little bit. Now, part D, what happens to the interval as the sample size increases? What happens is that interval, the distance from the low end to the high end, it's getting smaller and smaller. The interval decreases as you increase your sample size, which makes the interval more useful to you. As the bigger the sample size you get, the more accurate your interval is. So you can say interval decreases, which is good, as sample size increases.